What are the side effects of saffron? We are going to answer one of the questions that have been sent to us about the side effects of saffron. So basically, what are the side effects of saffron?
Side effect is a little bit a strong word for saffron. However, if you take anything out of the ordinary or out of the balance, so it's going to have a side effect.
Okay.
Our body, for instance, contains 70% water, more than even 70%. And if you take, Alex, 12 glass of water per day or 12 liter of the water per day, you practically sink yourself.
Okay, so you can actually drown in water.
You can practically,
if you drink too much.
Exactly. Right. I mean, as simple as that. Yeah.
So what happens if we have too much saffron?
Well, first of all, it's almost impossible for anyone to take too much saffron.
Okay. What are the dosages that
we
should take?
The dosage of the saffron started from 20 milligram, which is the 1/50th of the gram, goes all the way to half a gram in really, really, really strong cases.
Okay, 20 milligram to
500 milligrams. Yeah.
In extreme cases.
Yeah, in extreme cases. I mean, and not even every day. So for half a gram is not going to be everyday cases. Yeah. Saffron, as we all know, is the stigma from the plant Sativus crocus.
The stigma or threads, some people call it.
Yeah. So obviously carries a lots of natural pollen, which is the plant base. So it's a flower with the stigma and lots of pollen.
Just like any other flower.
Exactly. So the reason that many people may experience the little bit of the kind of, you know, I don't know, allergy look situation is coming from the pollen.
Right.
And it's coming from the fact that saffron is a plant base.
Yeah. So that's one of the side effects of saffron, if you are already allergic to pollens.
Yeah. However, it's not a life-threatening at all. I mean, I never heard or read or I never seen any research done about the matter of saffron, I don't know, killing someone or all those things.
Especially if you're only taking, let's say, like 50 milligrams per day, which is a tiny, tiny amount, the amount of pollen that's going to be in 50 milligrams of saffron
is almost, you cannot even count it.
Okay, all right. But if you are extremely allergic to everything, including pollens, then we suggest that you seek advice from a health professional, your doctor. Yeah.
Or one of the easiest way to test it is having the saffron, just a small amount of it, and apply it on your skin as a dry saffron.
Okay.
And a little bit play with it. See what is the skin reaction. If you have such a reaction to pollen, your skin will attract it straight away. And you will notice the kind of, you know, eczema or rash into your skin. Yeah.
Okay.
If you have any allergy.
Shall I read this list for you?
Well, sure. Yeah.
Or do you have something more general you want to talk
about? Well, something that is important, Alex, and I want people to know is, if you born in the society that using a saffron is not part of the culture, I would suggest that when you decided to take a saffron, take it easy and take it gradually and slowly.
Okay.
So and
the reason she's saying that is because we are born in Iran.
Yeah.
And in Iran, saffron is used in just about everything.
Everything, yeah.
From morning to night, from soups to desserts.
So we practically having saffron in our blood even before we born.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. So, but if you are from a Western country that saffron is not part of your culture, then you should consider these advice.
Well, and look, I want to really stress this one. Even if you are not considering to taking a caution, I will guarantee that you will never ever get harmed by using the 50 milligram of saffron a day. That's absolutely safe.
We do have other videos that explains the benefits of taking saffron. In this video, however, we are only focusing on the side effects or what could happen that you probably is negative. Yeah. So some people have asked about dry mouth.
Yeah.
What do you think about
that? Well, honestly, I think the number of the people in the whole world that they may experience such a side effects is so little. There is no any research about it.
Okay.
I haven't seen any research whatsoever. Another thing is some people taking saffron with other things, so it might be the effect of those things, not the saffron.
Okay.
For instance, if you take saffron with the turmeric, So the high amount of the turmeric will create lots of blood, lots of dryness in your mouth.
Okay.
So, and you would never know which one is the cause of the dry mouth.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. The second point I have here is people who are thinking that anxiety is one of the side effects of taking saffron, and agitation. Is that correct?
Well, if someone having a kind of, you know, habit of getting lots of adrenaline, so obviously saffron is working against adrenaline.
Okay.
Yeah.
So by taking saffron, exactly, you're reducing your adrenaline.
You're reducing the adrenaline, therefore
you're getting
you
more testosterone.
Feel. Yeah. Yeah.
No, you're getting more...
Serotonin. Yeah, more serotonin is against adrenaline. So serotonin bring you down, make you calm, make you relaxed, make you collective, whereas adrenaline take you high. So the highness of the adrenaline is not really a study, whereas the calmness of serotonin is very steady. That's why for those people who are
addicted to
junkie,
okay,
so it's really hard to take saffron.
Okay,
yeah,
so
yeah,
that will actually go against what the
exactly,
habit is,
yeah,
and cause some sort of anxiety
exactly,
in them. Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. Drowsiness.
Well, it is natural drowsiness. Obviously, when you take saffron and the serotonin goes up, your
okay,
body, it will go to the resting and relaxing condition. Yeah.
Okay. So don't forget, during the evening hours, if you don't have a screen stuck to your face, which is emitting blue light, during the evening hours, your body takes all the serotonin that it has and turns it into melatonin,
yeah,
which gets you ready for sleep. So that could be, if you're feeling sleepier or you're getting deeper sleep, it could be because your serotonin levels are going up. Is
absolutely,
that correct?
Absolutely, yes,
yeah,
it is correct. Yeah.
The next one was low mood. So I'm not sure how taking saffron can bring your mood down, or low mood.
Okay, Alex, look, human is the soup of the hormones.
Sure.
So especially in our brain, we get a lots of neurotransmitter that they are controlling our kind of, you know, general mood.
Mm.
So if we are really happy, or if we are low, or if we are just, you know, here and there. So we need to look at the individual to see what is their condition.
Okay.
If they are experiencing with the severe Alzheimer, if they are experiencing severe, I don't know, depression, if they are experiencing severe, so many different type of, you know, disorder in the brain, in the nervous system. So obviously, saffron coming through the story and adding more
serotonin,
it will change the balance with the hormones that they experience for a long time.
Okay.
But I truly believe, and this is not just my beliefs, many scientists, they believe that as you build up the serotonin in your body through taking a saffron as a natural source of building serotonin, so the rest of the hormones gradually and slowly will balance. That's why scientists putting in lots of light for the last 10-15 years over the usage of the saffron for the patient with the ADHD,
yeah,
with the case of depression,
anxiety
and
MS.
So many different, yeah, MS,
yeah,
as well as Alzheimer,
yeah,
dementia, and all those type of different genre of the brain and the nervous system,
yeah,
disorders.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just to conclude, using regular dosages of saffron promotes production of serotonin in your gut, which is 70% of serotonin is created in the gut, and also it reduces free radicals in the body, or actually helps the body neutralize the free radicals in the system by having high dosages of antioxidants. So these are not side effects, obviously, these are the benefits of saffron. I just thought I'll throw it in this video just so that you know. And regarding dosage of saffron, we will have another video which we talk exclusively about how much saffron you need to be taking depending on your condition. And we have other videos about how to prepare your saffron if you are using it in terms of medicinal benefits.
Sure. Well, Alex, what I like to mention to everyone is what we try is we're trying to make saffron as easy as people to take. So if you endure us and if you stay with us, you will learn so many different, very simple way of how to bring saffron to your everyday life and how to enjoy saffron and how to know what is the goodness about the saffron.
And that brings this video to conclusion.
Sure.
Thank you so much. Here's a little discount code. If you guys are interested to purchase some saffron, experience the benefits of saffron for yourself, please use this code at the checkout.
Please don't hesitate to ask any question that you have. If we do know the answer, we will respond to you. And if we do not, we will do the research on your behalf and we will find the solution. Cheers. Thank you.
Bye.